week. This week, we're going to be looking at a delightful little creature, and I'm getting ready to say a very difficult word. He is called Moratus speciosus. Not bad. I think I said that correctly. It's the peacock spider. He's a tiny little fellow, but he loves to get down and dance. And there's no better dancer than this tiny spider. Check out this cute little video of him getting down. Hi friends, we're over here at this part of the studio, and this is my collection of insects. I collect insects of all different kinds, from beetles to spiders, praying mantis, butterflies. This is just a little bit of my collection because I like to look at real specimens when I need to draw one, or just to enjoy the beauty of them. Sometimes I just like them as a decoration. I have a couple here that are kind of interesting. This is my praying mantis. He's yellow. I think he looks kind of cool. I have an amazing butterfly here. It looks good on the front, and it looks pretty good on the back. And my favorite one is this collection of jewel beetles from Africa and South America. I got this while I was visiting Paris. There's a famous taxidermy shop there that you can go and visit, and it has like two or three floors. And on the second floor is like the insect wing, and there's like hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of drawers filled with all different insects, from butterflies to beetles to moths. And you can create your own piece of artwork while you're there, and they'll frame it for you and you get to take it home. And this is the one I did when I was in Paris. Thank you for enjoying my little collection here. Let's go to the demonstration table and let's get started on our next art project. Okay, here is my example of a peacock spider. Now I did it two ways. And the reason I did it two ways is this is a pretty challenging art project for all of you. And I wanna make sure all of you will have success at this. So there's two ways that you can do this, and you're gonna decide which way works for you, or perhaps both will work for you. First things first is that you're gonna get a piece of paper. I'm actually working pretty small today. I made a square, but you could actually cut your paper in half if you want to. I just wanted a square because he's kind of tiny, and I really wanted just to be able to focus on that insect, the spider, rather than have that whole space. And what I did is I'm gonna fold that piece of paper in half, okay? And the reason I'm doing that is I'm gonna show you a little bit of a trick that a lot of artists use to get the mirrored image on the other side to create symmetry, because everything is down the middle. What I want on this side, I want on that side, and that's symmetry. So with that, I'm gonna draw my first part of his fan. So that's his little butt, and it's shaped like a fan, but I'm only gonna do half of it. So I'm gonna do sort of a round shape like this that flattens out to the bottom. Notice that I am just going from one part of the fold to the next part of the fold, and it looks like the part of a letter. For me, it looks like the letter C. The next part is I'm gonna make another small shape here that extends from that C, and it sort of looks like an L. And then I'm gonna do another one that's gonna be the top of his, not really his head, but sort of his, I don't know what you call those. where he gets all his food. There's a word for it. I will think of it before I go. But that's the mandibles, I think, that collect the food. That's it. And then I'm going to do two legs here at the bottom. I'm going to do another leg here that's kind of folded. Notice that it's elongated U, and these are also elongated U's. These are all shapes that you know. And then the last leg, that really tall leg, the kind of those two legs that he sort of splays out when he dances, that goes way up here and then back down. And it's kind of skinny. And then I'm going to do just two eyes on this side. Okay? One big large one and then a medium sized one. Now here comes the magic. Here comes that trick. And it's really important to use a pencil that gets really nice and dark. So you want to make your lines nice and dark. I'm going to fold this paper over, and using the side of another of your pencil, I am going to rub this. Now, it's important that you make your lines nice and dark when you do the drawing, so it rubs off on the other side. And there you can see sort of a ghost image of that spider. And just go over it, make it a little bit darker. And you will have that symmetry, and everybody will be like, how did they do that? You did such a good job. And you're like, mm-hmm. And there is your perfect little spider. And from there, you can decide how do you want their patterns to be. That spider has many different patterns. And you can, I like to make up my own. And once I get that done, I can start coloring. If you have a black Sharpie, I do like to outline. It makes my lines a little bit crisper, so you can start outlining your lines there. And then you can start coloring the areas that you want. When you get everything colored, one of the things that makes this spider a spider is the fact that he has tiny little hairs all over him. So that means that you have to go back and add all those tiny little hairs all around the fan part of his body and around his legs. And when you color, I like to color his body like a solid color, and then with a black pen, add all those dash marks and things that make it look like hair. And that's, you're texturizing him. So you're creating a texture when you do that. So this one's a little bit tricky. You're gonna, if you wanna do one that's a little bit simpler and one that sort of pops out, because I made this one sort of like pop out so it looks like he's moving it, like he's dancing. You do it the same way. You're gonna make a fan and you're gonna cut that out. You cut that out, do your patterns on your fan. So you will do whatever patterns you want on the fan. And you'll color it. Take a second piece of paper, fold it in half. And now this time, use this to sort of gauge how you, where the body, where his fan is. And then you do the first part of the head, the bottom, the mandibles, and then the little legs, the little folded leg, and then the long leg. Do that magic trick that I showed you. And I didn't do it long enough. And you get your shape. And you trace it in your little legs. And what you do is you color that, color it all. I colored the background. I did the texture, and then I made a little spiral. So basically I cut out a circle, and then I make a spiral. Believe it or not, spirals are the easiest things to cut. People don't realize that. And what I did is I glued this bottom half to the paper. And then this part to his little fan structure. And then I glued it down, so now this one, it moves. So he's kind of cute, moving. So that is Maratus speciosus. I like saying that. It sounds like a magical spell. I hope you enjoyed the little spider. I'm looking forward to seeing all your spiders dance across my screens. Have a terrific week. Okay.
I really like this book here.
Oh, should I do it again?
No.
Oh, okay. All right, so that's that spider.
What's the next one called?
The next one is called, should it be like iridescent beetles or something? Oh, are we getting, where are we getting pizza from? Are they picking it up?
Oh my God, it's 4:04.
Pizza and yeah. Soda. I don't think I have any more soda left, do I?
Right, hold on.
Oh, these are so cute. Oh, we have to scan these. Oh, that chippy. Oh, that chili. No. What are you looking up? Are you finding something for the cat?
For the beetle. They're bringing me the beetles.
Oh, the Oh, I could get started, right? Is this thing still going?
Yeah.
Why am I waiting for you? I was so stupid.
I don't know.
I was confused. How do you know? How do I know if it's still running? Oh yeah. Okay. Oh my God, and they're waiting.
Hey, what do you call this one?
What?
The thing? Iridescent beetle?
Yeah, I guess so. So our art project this week is a collaged beetle using tons of scrap paper around your house and creating all the different parts of the beetle and pasting them down on a background and getting a beautiful, I think a really beautiful piece of artwork. I think you could do a series of these and have some incredible pictures on your wall. So the first thing I do is I start hunting for my materials. And I'm fortunate enough to have some beautiful scrap paper and one of my other favorite types of paper, newspaper. And I'm gonna use newspaper for the very thin parts of the wing where you see the different veins and the actual like skeleton structure. It's not really a skeleton structure, but you know what I'm talking about, that sort of weather vane look. So that I'm gonna use newspaper for that. And all the other parts of the beetle's body, I'm gonna be using some nice colored paper. And I picked colors in a color family. So when I did start hunting for paper, if I found a color that I liked, I tried to find other colors in that family. So this one was like my oranges and blues. Even inside this blue, there's some orange, so it's really tied together nicely. This one is silver, purple, and blue. If you don't have fancy papers, don't distress, because some of my favorite colors and papers is magazines. So I went about and I found a nice, look at this cover, of the New Yorker. It's just beautiful greens and pink. That's going to be a great piece of paper to use. Also, a food magazine. I love the colors. When you cut out this into shapes, nobody knows that it's basil and prosciutto. Here's some green beans and squash. Great color choices there. Once I cut that out, no one knows what it is. This Ford, I love the green and white. Perfect. This tractor, no one's going to see the words, but I like this green and black. So these could be used to create your beetle as well. So don't distress. Go find a magazine and get some really good examples for yourself. Stay in your color families. So I'm going to get my base ready. And the first step I do is I'm going to build the bottom part of my beetle. And I'm going to fold my paper in half and I'm going to draw the body. And then I'm going to cut that out. And that's the body. Now I'm going to draw sort of the middle part. And I measure that by doing half and then making a shape, sort of a U shape, if you can see that. And I cut that out. And put that together like so. The second part is the head. And I made a little shape like that. Make it sort of rounded. Flat on the bottom. That's its head. His wings. So I'm going to do the first set of wings out of newspaper. And I have a template on the website that you can use. I trace that. And I folded my paper so I get two. And I gotta cut that in half. And those are my top wings. Or maybe his bottom wings, I should say. Which are gonna go like that. And then lastly, I am going to draw these wings. And I'm gonna use this as a template because I want them to be sort of the same size. And I'm going to cut that. And then I'm going to cut it in half. And there, I pretty much have all my pieces together. So the next thing I'm going to do is glue these down. And this is the order that I glue them in. I do the big body first. Then I do the middle part of his body. Then the head. Then the wings. And I put them right on the middle. So where the body in that part meets. I think I need to move this over a little bit. Wasn't centered. Now it's centered. Yay. And then I do the last wings like so. It goes pretty fast. You can make a lot of these and really have a nice, beautiful collection. And the last thing I do is I add the legs. And I just take a straight line here, and then I kind of curve it out a little bit. Maybe add some unknown little texture. A little antenna. You just be kind of goofy with these legs. Doesn't have to be perfect. And there you go. You have a cool little beetle. And people are really going to be really wowed by these. I think they're pretty impressive, especially when you have more than one. I look forward to seeing these amazing beetles that you're going to create. Have a fantastic week. Hello, Academy Stars, and welcome to the second week of Insects. Oh, my solo is in. And welcome back to the second week of Insects. Now I did it again. It's called Insect Week, right? Welcome to the part two. I can't get going. We are going to be looking at an insect called Moroctis. Moroctis speciosus. He's a unique little fellow that likes to do a little bit of dancing, which we all like to get. Get my thoughts together. He may be small, but he really knows how to get down.
This is great.